Hello and welcome to NewsClick. I'm Paranjoy Guha Thakurta, and with me here in the studio, I have a 40-year-old political analyst, cum advertiser, advertising expert, cum data analyst. He's many things rolled into one. I'm very happy to welcome Narendra Nag, co-founder of Anthro.Ai, formerly a digital officer in a firm in Norway. In the 20 years that you've been working, Narendra, for about half you've been a journalist, the other half you've been in communications and advertising. In journalism, you worked with the Hindustan Times, CNN, IBN, NewsX, Mint.
Yes.
And as a communications and advertising person, you worked in China, Japan, India, and the US, among other with the big publicists. All right. Narendra, the reason why a lot of people are very keen to know your views today is your organization has projected that the Bharatiya Janata Party could get as few as 21 out of the 80 Lok Sabha seats in the elections which are over, the results of which will be declared on the 23rd of May. And you have said that the Mahagathbandhan, if you call it, Bahujan Samaj Party, Samajwadi Party, Rashtriya Lok Dal, would win over 54 or thereabouts. तो नरेन भाई अगर आप ठीक है तो आप तो हीरो बन जाएंगे मगर बहुत सारे लोग ये कह रहे हैं कि ये एग्जिट पोल और कुछ कह रहे हैं और अगर एंड इफ यू अप्रूव रॉन्ग लोग कहेंगे कि ये कहां से ये हमारा बंदा आया ऐसे भविष्यवाणी कर रहे हैं भारतवर्ष के सबसे बड़ा राज्य इसके बारे में यस योर व्यूज
वेल माय रिस्पांस टू दैट इज वेरी सिंपल वी decided to do this to test out systems and methods that have traditionally not been applied in the political space as far as we are aware. And from the very beginning, we've been fine with the idea of being wrong. We don't think we are, but we've been okay with that because whether we are right or wrong, there's a lot of learning in both for us. That learning will help us strengthen our models, strengthen our methods, and hopefully be able to analyze and understand human motivations and behavior better. That genuinely is the only reason why we wanted to do this. Because an exercise of this sort doesn't come along often, where you have so many people who care so deeply about something participating.
No, everybody knows that Uttar Pradesh is the most populous state in India. One out of six Indians live in Uttar Pradesh. If Uttar Pradesh was an independent country, it would have been the sixth most populous country in the world after China, India, Indonesia, the United States and Brazil. Or Uttar Pradesh has the diversity, the heterogeneity. Jis tarah se vividhita hai Bharatvarsh mein, aap Uttar Pradesh ek rajya mein milenge. So is that the reason why you chose Uttar Pradesh? Or is it because, as the old saying goes, the road to Delhi is via Lucknow?
Well, that was that was definitely part of the attraction of the state. Uski jo political mehatva informed the decision, right? We wouldn't want to do something which didn't really matter. If we were doing it in a state which didn't really matter, we wouldn't actually have enough signals out there to help test our models. Doing it in a state like UP gives us the diversity of our country. It gives us scale and size of a country, and it gives us the importance of a country as well. So I think that those were the reasons which sort of drove our decision more than anything
else. If you are saying, if it's right, if the Bharatiya Janata Party and NDA ke agar bandhan 73 se 21 tak gir jate hain, tab kisi waqt bhi Modi ji dobara Pradhan Mantri nahi banenge.
It is very difficult for us to predict that. The reason for that is, agar hum log Uttar Pradesh mein sahi hue, और मध्य प्रदेश राजस्थान छत्तीसगढ़ वेस्ट बंगाल ये सारे स्टेट्स में वो पूरा स्वीप कर जाते हैं जैसे कि कुछ एक्सिट पोल्स ने बोला है तो फिर से प्रधानमंत्री बन सकते हैं हमारा काम ये नहीं है प्रिडिक्ट करना कि वो प्रधानमंत्री बनेंगे कि नहीं हमारा काम बहुत सिंपल है
ये जितने सारे एग्जिट पोल्स आए हैं टाइम्स नाउ VMR कह रहे हैं 58 ABPC वोटर कह रहे हैं 25 इंडिया टीवी CNX 50 टुडेज चाणक्य 65 रिपब्लिक टेलीविजन और सी वोटर एक ही सी वोटर एबीपी और रिपब्लिक दोनों के साथ है एक जगह में 25 और एक जगह में 38 पता नहीं एक बंदा किया कि दूसरा बंदा किया रिपब्लिक भारत जन की बात 45 to 57. News Nation, 38 to 40. India Today Access, 62 se 68. और आप अकेला कह रहे हैं ये 21 तक गिर जाएगा. एबीपी सी वोटर सबसे नज़दीक आया वो 25 का, आपने कहा 21. सो आइदर यू विल बी प्रूव्ड,
आइदर वी विल बी वेरी रॉन्ग or we'll be very right. It's going to be one of the two. It can't be anything in between. We actually think that if we are wrong, then we're going to be wrong at so many levels that it's not going to be 21. It won't be like 21 to 30, right? It will be like the BJP is winning 65 or 68 or 70 seats or something.
So you're saying it will either be the BJP will get to very well, close to what it got last time, or it will do very badly.
And we haven't seen
predicting
anything to suggest that it will do very well. We could, of course, be wrong. And we're happy being wrong, but we haven't seen anything yet which would suggest that.
आपने बहुत सारे कारण दिखाया. आपने कहा, आपने यहाँ पे कह रहे हैं कि ये जो भारतीय जनता पार्टी का जो वोट शेयर 3% से 6% गिरने का संभावना है, और ये जो गठबंधन है बहुजन समाज पार्टी और सपा का, समाजवादी पार्टी का, 2% से 5% बढ़ेगा. तो ये आपने, हाउ डिड यू कम अक्रॉस, व्हाई डिड यू arrive at these figures?
So, you know, one of the things that we've been looking at is what happened in the bipoles. So in the bipoles, it wasn't just the when the SP and the BSP came together and won them, they didn't just win them by adding up their vote shares. They actually got more than what their vote shares were in 2014. And as we've studied the state over the last, what, now 6 months now, actively, we saw that when they were winning, there was always an additive factor. That additive factor could come from Muslim voters who were moving away from the Congress and choosing to vote for them because they believed that this was a more winnable candidate. So there are other people who are sort of joining together to vote for a candidate they think will win. So we didn't believe that they would just win by the addition of the SP and the BSP vote. We sort of saw that already happening, that there would be other voters.
बहुत सारे जो हमारे जो राजनीतिक विश्लेषक है उनका कहना है, देखिए सपा को कौन मदद कर रहे हैं? सपा को मदद कर रहे हैं जो OBCs है, अदर बैकवर्ड क्लासेस, इसमें यादव लोग, और आपने खुद कहा कि इस बार जाति के वित्ती में लोग वोट देंगे. तो अगर जो यादव नहीं है मगर OBCs है, वो क्यों इस बार एक साथ जाएंगे सपा के साथ, जो विधानसभा चुनाव में नहीं गए थे नोटबंदी के बाद. दूसरी बात है कि साथ साथ लोग कह रहे हैं कि ठीक है, बहुजन समाज पार्टी का जो वोट है, जातव वोट और बाकी सारे दलितों, ठीक है, उसका ट्रांसफर हो जाएगा वोट, वो सपा का उम्मीदवार के पास चले जाएंगे. बट नॉट द अदर वे अराउंड.
वेल, आई एक्चुअली वी फाउंड समथिंग वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. द जातव वोट इन द फर्स्ट फ्यू फेजेस, less of it transferred than in the last few phases. And the reason for it is that the initials, there was a seminal moment. The moment is when Mayawati and Mulayam share a stage together. At that point, even the Jatav voter who was unlikely to go and vote for the Yadavs,
आपका कहना यह है,
correct,
वो guest house घटना के 25 साल के बाद,
correct, is, you know, the, for whatever reason, there was a certain section that said, let's just wait and watch. So I don't think we saw as much Jatavs turnout for the Gadbandhan in the first phase as we did in the seventh.
जब बहन मायावती और मुलायम सिंह यादव जी एक मंच में खड़े थे,
तब उस ये माहौल बदल गया. Hugely impactful at multiple levels. The second hugely impactful thing was to see Dimple Yadav touch Mayawati's feet in another rally, the one that happened in Kannauj. And both of these events, to understand, you know, you can sort of say these things don't matter or are normative within a sort of urban context, but these are not normative within the reality of the
आपने जो अंग्रेजी में लिखा है, in the run-up to 2014, Amit Shah moved quickly to capitalize on years of work by the BJP wooing non-Yadav OBCs, non-Jatav Dalits in Uttar Pradesh by picking office bearers, candidates from these communities. The BJP offered itself as a first party of choice for the people who were left out, in a sense, who felt left out by the Samajwadi Party, the Bahujan Samaj Party and the Congress. And the people had expectations rooted in what they believed had happened. Because look, keh rahe ji, jo zameeni sthar pe Yadav और जातव दुश्मन है, एक साथ कैसे वो एक उम्मीदवार को वोट देंगे, कैसे एक साथ आ गए? आई मीन तो एक्सेस टू पावर दैट ट्रांसलेट्स इनटू अ डिसप्रोपोर्शनेट शेयर ऑफ बेनिफिट्स एंड इंक्रीज रिस्पेक्ट इन देयर नेबरहुड्स. तो ये कैसे माहौल बदल गया आप कह रहे हैं?
आई एक्चुअली थिंक दिस स्टार्टेड विद द बाईपोल्स. इफ द बाईपोल्स हैड नॉट हैपेंड एंड हैड नॉट बीन पुल्ड ऑफ सक्सेसफुली, then these communities would, the existing sort of suspicions would have stayed. The second thing is that Akhilesh Yadav's role in the way that he has behaved with Mayawati all along, with great respect, by allowing her to be the senior partner or seem like the senior partner, by giving her more seats, there has been this constant sort of, you know, he's made sure, at the risk of sometimes perhaps alienating some of his own, the members of his own party, he has made sure that she has been accorded the respect which allows for people within communities to start to treat each other with less suspicion. And he started to define what the behavior should be.
Narendra, you know, and you have written that the people of UP might use these elections as an opportunity to treat Prime Minister Narendra Modi a lesson. And you quote William Congreve's famous lines of 1697, "Heaven hath no rage like love to hate return, nor hell a fury like a woman scorned." Aur aapne ye bhi kaha ki ye bhukamp nahi hai, ye ek undercurrent hai.
It's all an undercurrent. I actually call it an earthquake.
So aap keh rahe ye bhukamp hai.
Yeah, because you know, when one of the we kept picking up anger against the BJP for having picked Yogi Adityanath, actually having sprung him as a surprise chief minister after 2017. So you know, the old social coalition, and I hesitate to call it a social coalition. I'll call it a political sort of coalition, where they got the Kushwahas on board and the Kurmis on board and the other OBCs on board and many of the other non-Jatav Dalits on board. They didn't expect a Thakur chief minister. And they certainly didn't expect the sort of the semiotics of the Thakur chief minister to be as, to be what Yogi Adityanaths are. That's one thing which I think has played on some people. And this, there is a lack of respect in that choice, inherent in that choice.
आप कह रहे हैं कि बहुत सारे मुद्दा, आपने 100 के आसपास मुद्दा के इसके ऊपर आपने विश्लेषण किया, रिसोर्स क्रंच और जो शिक्षा जो प्रणाली है ये एकदम खत्म हो गया, आप बुनियादी ढांचा इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेफिसिट भी कह रहे हैं, आप पलायन के बारे में कहा, इंटरनल माइग्रेशन, आप ग्रामीण क्षेत्र में जो संकट चल रहे, फार्मर डिस्ट्रेस, अस वर्सेस देम, डेंटेड by demonetization, water woes, ballooning job crisis, और आपने बहुत ऐसे अंग्रेजी में सुर्खियाँ दिया, holy cow to holy terror. ये जो हमारे
we have had a little fun. You when you're doing work like this and you're primarily doing it for yourself, do not have not allow yourself to at least enjoy the work that you're doing would be a crying shame. So yeah, we have had a little fun with those headlines all along, not just.
तो आप कह रहे कि ये सारे मुद्दा these issues matter और बहुत लोग कह रहे हैं नहीं राष्ट्रवाद है, ये जो हिंदू मुसलमान के बीच जो भारतीय जनता पार्टी का जो विरोध करते हैं जिन लोगों, वो कह ये एक तरह से सांप्रदायिक शक्ति है. But you are saying the issues of religion, the issues of Ram Mandir, the issues of nationalism post Pulwama and Balakot will not matter, and these issues will matter?
No, I think they do matter, but they matter to the BJP voter. And it's very, we've also written about the formidable BJP voting bloc that they've managed to create. People who want the country to be post-caste, people who want a muscular national narrative, people who believe that it is possible to sort of escape the circumstances of their birth. And it's, most of these people will be urban. We have noticed that, but there is a larger section which aspires to these things, and we think that those people are voting for the BJP, and perhaps with good reason, because there is a worldview that they subscribe to which makes sense to them. It would be dangerous to dismiss them as using negative terms, because I would not dismiss the voter in that fashion. I actually, like, whenever we were studying them, we had a lot of empathy for them, because what they wanted was a better life. They but to a different prison.
तो आपने किस आप कौन सा तकनीक इस्तेमाल किया? आप कह रहे हैं कि जो तकनीक आपने इस्तेमाल किया एक तरह से it is unique, एक अभिनवत्ता है. आपने कहा Anthro.Ai is an experiment in alchemy between experienced communication specialists, data scientists, anthropologists, mathematicians, and between the human mind, heart, and our instincts and immersive data streams. We have ingested and analyzed nearly all publicly indexable data in or about UP, news stories, job postings, classifieds about farm equipment, questions, answers. You've tried to match this data to a 1 square kilometer grid of Uttar Pradesh. Sir, ye saral bhasha mein samjha dijiye. This is all gobbledygook to many people.
I mean, it's very simple. If agar aap 2019 ka, if you look at the network penetration, right, and the amount of things that we are saying, and you choose not to filter it by popularity. Okay, I will not look at things which everybody else is looking at. I will look at things perhaps that have just been said that nobody might be looking at. What you start to see then is a map of human expression. That human expression is personal, but it's also publicly posted, which means it's indexable. So like a search engine can go out and index all information that gets posted online, that information then becomes available to you. Now, as human beings, we can't necessarily consume that volume of information. But in the last few years, it's been possible to computationally process that information using multiple methods. There's no one single monolithic way of doing this. What those things do is give you patterns. That's when you bring in a trained anthropologist or you bring in somebody who understands these things and allow them to look at these patterns to understand what's going on. What are people's fears, or hopes,
jitne,
behaviors?
Jitne Bharatiya Janata Party ka samarthak hai, jo Dakshinpanthi website hai, aapko to gaali de rahe hai. Aapko Congress ka dalal bata diya. Aapko kaha ki aapne National Herald mein aapka lekh chhap gaya aur aapne bola ki they're questioning your motives.
Oh, they've also called me a commie coder, which I actually quite like.
Commie coder.
I'm going to get a t-shirt printed. But we don't actually have a problem with that because we surface that stuff most of the time before they find it. Many of those right-wing portals have helped us a lot to help us understand the BJP voter or the right-wing sort of Indian. And especially on places like Bharat Rakshak and all, you'll find fairly cogent arguments being made by these guys. I wouldn't dismiss them ever. And I'm okay with being called names because it doesn't really matter to me. And some of these names I actually like as well. But we don't have an issue with being called names. I think our data net allows us to study people in an empathetic way and then arrive at the conclusions that we arrive at, which is a fairly multi-layered process, I might add. I mean, I don't want to miss.
Narendra, humko 23 May tak intezar karna padega. We'll have to wait and watch. We'll know whether you're right or not. You've stuck your neck out. Aur aapne jaisa kaha, if we are right, we will double down on what we've learned and continue to build our systems. If we are wrong, we will learn from our mistakes, fix our systems and be stronger for it. Samay batayenge. Thank you once again for giving us your time. And thank you very much for being with NewsClick. And we'll know really after the 23rd of May whether what Narendra Nag and his team at Anthro.Ai, and I must mention some of the members of his team, they include Rahil Khurshid, Aruna Handig, Zoya Wahi and others, whether their prediction that the Bharatiya Janata Party's number and the NDA's number would come crashing down from 73 out of 80 to 21 or thereabouts. They said they are not very sure about 8 or 9 seats. But even if it's like 30, that would be a very, very significant loss for the BJP. We'll know only after the 23rd of May. Thank you for being with us. Keep watching NewsClick.